joined the Air Force because I came from a military family. My father was in the Air Force. My grandfather was in the Army. And so I was encouraged to join the Air Force by just being in a military family. But also I wanted to go to college. And to go to college, I needed to earn some money. And my father told me that joining the Air National Guard would allow me a way to earn money so I could go to college. After I got my degree and I became a commissioned officer, I ended up becoming I worked in civil engineering, and in civil engineering, I did work with buildings. So just construction inspection, designing electrical systems, wiring, things like that for buildings. I built buildings for the Air Force. I got to travel to Canada and build buildings for the Canadian Air Force. And that was my first job in the Air Force with my electrical engineering degree. Later on, I actually became a medical officer and used my engineering degree in a position called bioenvironmental engineering, which for civilians is OSHA. It's like occupational health and safety, and dealing with how to be safe in the workplace and how chemicals affect the body and how you can protect yourself. I am actually working with what's called merino wool, which is a very soft wool. It's actually merino fleece. So this has actually been taken, sheared off of a merino sheep. It's been cleaned, and then after that it's been processed into what's called roving. And so with this roving, I can spin it, and as I add the twist into it, I'm actually making yarn. And with this yarn, I can knit or I can weave. Normally, after I finish spinning my yarn, and the next process would be for me to dye it, and then I could use it in whatever I wanted. I do knit with a lot of my yarn, but I also weave with it. I am using cotton, and I am weaving cotton towels. And so this is the cotton yarn. Everybody has their own technique on how they throw. And this is just the atmosphere. And so I'm treadling. This is an 8-harness loom, which means it has 8 of these. And based on which ones go up, that's how the pattern is created. Just starting out, so it should be a while. But then when you'll see me use different feet. So 1 to 4, I use my left foot, and 5 through 8, I use my right foot. I'm doing this. I just throw it side to side, and then I use this. I'm beating it to put all the threads together, pull the yarns together, and so that's called the beater. Different than the beaters that you see, like, you know, on Hogwarts. This one just does yarn. do sell my yarn. Sometimes people want to buy yarn, and so I do just sell the yarn that I make. I don't use it all for my knitting and for my own projects, but I do make yarn for other people as well. Thank you. I appreciate this opportunity to talk about my work and my experiences with you.